The message of the report we are issuing today is clear. Shared responsibility and global solidarity in response to the impacts of COVID-19. It is a call to action. It is essential that developed countries immediately assist those less developed to bolster their health systems and their response capacity to stop transmission. Otherwise, we face the nightmare of the disease spreading like wildfire in the global south, with millions of deaths and the prospect of the disease re-emerging where it was previously suppressed. Let us remember that we are only as strong as the weakest health system in our interconnected world. I am particularly concerned with the African continent, and I strongly encourage the G20 to move ahead with the G20 Africa initiative as proposed at the summit. What is needed is a large-scale, coordinated and comprehensive multilateral response amounting to at least 10% of global GDP. Developed countries can do it by themselves, and some are indeed doing so. But we must massively increase the resources available to the developing world by expanding the capacity of the International Monetary Fund, namely through the issuance of special drawing rights, and also of the other international financial institutions to rapidly inject resources in the countries that need them. Coordinated swaps among central banks can bring liquidity to emerging economies. And debt alleviation must be a priority, including immediate waivers on interest payments for 2020. The United Nations system is fully mobilized, providing guidance for global efforts, supporting country responses, and placing our supply chains at the world's disposal. And to support our efforts, the United Nations is establishing a new multi-partner trust fund for COVID-19 response and recovery to support low- and middle-income countries to respond to the emergency and recover from the socio-economic shock. UN resident coordinators around the world will be the drivers of the UN response on the ground, ensuring that the wide and diverse expertise and assets of the United Nations system are used in the most effective and efficient way to support countries. The recovery from the COVID-19 crisis must lead to a different economy. Everything we do during and after this crisis must be with a strong focus on building more equal, inclusive and sustainable economies and societies that are more resilient in the face of pandemics, climate change, and the many other global challenges we face. What the world needs now is solidarity. With solidarity, we can defeat the virus and build a better world.